Hello, I'm Chef Makarnd, and today I'll show you how to make Badami Halwa, Karachi Halwa, Bombay Karachi Halwa. It has so many names. Some people call it as a cornstarch halwa. So basic ingredient in this is cornstarch. And what happens, like, when we boil this cornstarch in sugar syrup, it starts coagulating. It starts coagulating so fast that we have to be very careful not to heat up the syrup and put that thing later on. If some of you have tried, like, how to make Chinese food, like, they put a little bit of liquid cornstarch or cornstarch dissolved in water. So the original thing should be a little bit cooled off, and then we can add cornstarch into it. So when we mix this cornstarch into cold substance, it won't form lumps, and slowly we'll increase the heat. That's the best solution for that. The ingredients which we are using to make this halwa is cornstarch, sugar. We'll be making sugar syrup out of it. Water is obviously essential because we'll be mixing these things together. Then clarified butter or ghee. To prevent crystallization of the sugar once we make it, we need some acidic substance. And best thing is like lemon juice or lime juice. So I have a couple of lemons. I'll be cutting and I'll squeezing later on. I have some chopped cashews and sliced almond as a decoration. To give the flavor, saffron extract and few strands of saffron. And I'll be using this electric pink because we'll be making pink or nice red color Mumbai halwa. You can use any color of your choice. First, I'll be mixing some water in this cornstarch. And I'll make sure that it doesn't have any lumps. It easily gets dissolved, so not to worry much about it. So just see the consistency, it should be very liquidy. If it is thick, what happens is very difficult for us to later on mix it together. The proportion is not fixed here, but roughly around one part of cornstarch and then couple of parts of water. And we are going to cook it on this pan. Just to avoid burning of the sugar, I'm adding a little bit of water. And this is four times the proportion of cornstarch. So the key ingredient in this is, like, before it gets hot, we have to put this together. Otherwise, as I have told before, it will form lumps. So I'm adding this cornstarch, which I have dissolved in the water. This will make first sugar to dissolve, and then it will get cooked into that sugar syrup. I have turned the heat on low, reason being I don't want these cornstarch lumps to form before it gets cooked. Otherwise, cornstarch will get cooked before this sugar syrup is formed. We can add little more water, or we have to judge it. And water is also four times the quantity of cornstarch. So I'm talking about cornstarch which is in dry form. Now I can see sugar is dissolved almost. And once sugar is dissolved, I'll start heat a little bit higher, but not much. The reason being, again, same thing. We have to be very cautious and very clear about one thing, that cornstarch coagulates so fast, it makes lumps so fast, so we have to do it gradually and slowly so the texture remains nice. So now I have put the gas on a little bit of high heat. I remember my mom used to make it, and she used to soak wheat or wheat grains, and then after soaking, she used to grind it and extract that starch from it. Once it starts boiling, it starts becoming transparent. Some people, they like it too much chewy. So if water is a little bit of less, then that texture becomes more chewy. If it is more, it becomes a little bit of softer. I personally like soft texture of this. Now we can see, this is getting cooked. And I'm always making sure like it is not get burning from the bottom. And I'm using this non-stick pan, so it's very easy for me to handle the halwa. See, it is thickening now. And almost at this stage, I'll be adding ghee. Now we have to be very careful. And I'm again keeping this gas on low flame, because what happens, if it starts burning, it loses the transparency. It has thickened now, and this is the time when I'll be adding some ghee into it. Now this ghee gets incorporated into it. It's better to add liquid ghee so that you can handle it very easily. But even if it is a bit solid kind of, that's fine. Slowly and steadily. Now you can see even change in the color. Overall color has changed. It has become yellowish because here we get ghee of cow, and that is having more of carotenoids, and that's why it's yellow in color. Again, I am adding a little bit of ghee. Now what happens with this ghee? Ghee acts as a counter for the chewiness. If I'm just boiling this continuously, what happens is it becomes like a gum, very sticky substance. It won't be edible kind of. So this ghee prevents that, and ghee balances the structure. And even you can see like it's just moving very easily. So at this stage, I'm stopping. Only reason is like, you know, I don't want to incorporate too much of ghee into it because I don't want to make it too soft. Some chewiness should remain in that. This is a time when I'm putting just additional ingredients. Always keep in mind while doing this, gas should be on very low flame. So first I'll be putting this color. This is gel, so it's very concentrated, so I have to be very quick. Now this non-stick pan is so good quality pan, so halwa is just running around. It has given nice red color. And for flavoring, I'll be adding saffron extract with a little bit of saffron strands. And these chopped cashews is smelling so nice because of this saffron. You can add a little bit of sliced almonds as well. So these are blanched and sliced almonds. So it gives nice texture to halwa. Now I'll be cutting lemon and I'll squeeze it, a squeeze of lemon. I'm preventing these seeds to fall into it. And as I said, acidity of lemon will prevent crystallization. So texture remains nice, transparent. I don't want to cook it further because after this stage, it starts drying up and then it will lose the transparency and color of it. So now I'm switching off the gas. In the meantime, I'll just preparing a small dish. I'll just grease this tray. And onto it, I'm putting this. See, this just easily passed there. And still it is a little bit of hot, not much. I'll just put a little bit of oil into it, top of it. It's very easy to pat it and spread it evenly. The taste of consistency is very easy. Now I'm pushing it here. Now what happens? It is remaining almost there, like it's not losing the shape or it's not coming this side or not flattening. Obviously this is still hot, so still some softness is there, and that's okay. I'm decorating this with this sliced blanched almonds. It gives nice look. We have to keep this on its own, covered overnight or at least 7 to 8 hours. And if you want to keep in the fridge to make it fast, don't keep it in the freezer, because what happens then, it will spoil the texture. Because freezer, what freezer does is like it will start freezing from outside, and the core thing or the core part of this halwa will be just warm, or like it will not change the texture. So just to make it even, just keep it like that, let it cool off, and slowly even the water, little portion of it is getting evaporated, so it will become firm.